Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy from Van Allen & Company. It's Thursday, May 19th. I'm going to go over the markets with you for the day. You had an impressive comeback in soybeans today, closing 20 and a half cents off their low. They came down and traded about 24, 25 cents lower. And it looked like, you know, this was about the beginning of the end for soybeans. They really got hit hard. And what did you have? You had somebody come in here willing to buy weakness. And really, it looked like maybe a little bit of managed money coming in here and wanting to be active in soybeans, because fundamentally, there's not a whole lot to grasp bond to as far as that goes, and was able to close only down 3.75. So a very impressive comeback into those soybeans. Disappointing was the fact that corn wasn't able to come with it on the way back up. So soybeans pushed corn down about 12 cents lower, and all they were able to do was close down 9.5 cents lower there. So a little bit off of the lows, but not that much there. And then really, you probably had a little bit of wheat pressure weighing in on corn as well, being down 9 to 12 cents there. Corn had a very, very impressive corn sale once again for export sales this week. What you have now is into a time frame that is so much different than we were 2 months ago in corn, when really it looked like you were going to have to cut about 50 million metric tons or bushels off the S&D side export demand for USDA out of corn, because they were lagging export sale pace so bad. And then you've just had huge sale after huge sale after huge sale, and that's really been able to jump it up to pace. And what you have is 15 weeks left into the marketing year for corn. You need to average 212,000 bushel a week or less to stay into that time frame. Like I said, you've been having 1.4, 1.2, 1.7 million bushel sales on a week, so a lot higher than that 212,000. And so what you need to do is either have those corn sales really back off for the next 15 weeks drastically, or you need to have USDA come in here and bump up the export side of things on USDA, which will shrink the carryout as long as they don't offset it somewhere else. And so you do have that story there. It just wasn't enough to gain attention, and it looked like you wanted to have sellers of corn. Like I said, wheat market 9 to 12 cents lower. You did have unfriendly outside markets with a higher dollar, weaker crude, weaker Dow. So that could have put a little bit of pressure too across the board. Also had pressure into the meats. So you had live cattle down about $1.50, feeders down close to $2, lean hogs down about 50 to 60 cents there. So the pressure came forward. We'll have to wait to see if we see any cash sales. Otherwise, tomorrow is a cattle on feed on for cattle, and that's going to be a big deal, and that's going to really dictate how trade comes next week. The forecast does look like it added a little bit of moisture into some of those areas that were wet, but for the most part, there shouldn't be any planting problems. Temperatures do remain above average. We got a new updated model from NOAA for June. It looked like majority of the corn belt is going to be above average temperatures for June and above average to normal precip. There is a pocket of below down by southern Nebraska. It shouldn't be too much of a issue there. That's temperature wise. Otherwise, everything's looking really great for June. It shouldn't have any issues planting. We should be moving forward as far as that pace and staying ahead of the 5-year average. I do have to close with a disclaimer: trading futures and options involves risk loss and may not be suitable for all producers. Have a great day.